in Psalms, Proverbs, going to Isaiah. That's about midway in the book. All right? And if you get to the end of Isaiah, you will run into the book of Jeremiah. You follow me? Now I need you to go to the end of Jeremiah. I'm going to preach a little bit out of a book that you don't hear much about. It's the book of Lamentations. The third chapter. Lamentations. The third chapter. I try to help you find it so you wouldn't feel so lost. Amen. Well, one thing I have learned is I don't know where all the books are. So I love to look at the table of content.
Amen.
Amen, somebody.
Amen.
If you ask me what Nahum is, I can find it. But I'd have to do a little looking. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
Ezekiel saw the wheel way up in the middle of the air. But I'd have to look. Why'd you hook him up? Amen. So don't be playing deep, just ask. You got like these fellas here, all of them got phones now. See how deep they are now. Look at them, they're looking kind of, look at them. My God. All right. They old school still, don't let them play. In the book of Lamentations, this book being written, many theologians believe this is Jeremiah's writing. Amen. We're not going to argue with that right at this moment because I just want to lift something up to you. Lamentations beginning at the 21st verse. The writer, having talked about the rod of God's wrath is judgmental hand. The bitterness suffered when Israel did wrong and walked away and left their first love. He deals with some issues. In fact, I'll tell you what started the 19th verse. I want to make sure you get it all. 3 and 19, he comes to this conclusion. He says, remembering mine afflictions and my misery, the wormwood and the gall, that's misery, my brothers and sisters, having done wrong, my soul hath them still in remembrance and is humbled in me. Anybody know that when you do wrong, it's hard to forget? Try as you might. This I recall to my mind. Therefore, watch this. Have I hope? What hope, Jeremiah? It is of the Lord's mercy that we are not consumed. Why? Because his compassion fail not. They are new. How often? How often? Say it one more time. Why? Because great is God faithfulness. I'll talk to you a few minutes from the subject, the God of another chance. The God of another chance. God of another chance. No, I didn't say the God of a second chance.
All right.
Because if that were the case, none of us would qualify.
Amen.
Can I get a witness?
Amen.
Anybody here needed more than a second chance?
Amen.
I'm just curious. Don't make sure I'm in the right place now. Now, I need to tell you now, I need you to understand, I'm no longer dealing today with the perfect church. I'm just telling you now, so if you pot the perfect church, you can go to sleep. Because I'm not dealing with you today. I'm not dealing with those that could pat each other on the back talking about how good we did. Okay, because we ain't been all that good. Y'all do me a favor, one of y'all make it quick. The rest of y'all come out there. Do it. I'm not speaking of those who really come here because they just punching the clock. I want to talk to the ones who know that they haven't got it all together yet. Hey, I want to talk to the ones who want to know, want to can't understand when they think about today, when they think about yesterday, when they think about last week, when they think about last month, they wonder why are they not dead yet? Why haven't God just wiped me off the face of the earth? Now, I need you to understand before you get so sanctimonious, your righteousness is as filthy rag in God's eyesight. So you might look pretty, but you ain't pretty.